My dear students, in today's class, I will going to discuss about the Khilji's rule over Delhi Sultanate. Here, who were the Khilji's? Khilji's were the inhabitants of Turkestan, or they were originally belongs to Turkestan, or they were also Turks. And when they came to India, these Khilji's came to India during the invasions of Muhammad of Ghor. In 1190 AD, Muhammad of Ghor fought the first battle of Tarain with Prithviraj Chauhan. And when that battle was going on, this Muhammad of Ghor, he got a severe injury, or he received a fatal wound. So he was taken out of the battlefield by a Khilji soldier. Later, that is Muhammad bin Bakhtiyar Khilji, achieved victory for Muhammad Ghor over Bihar and Bengal. After that, these Khiljis went on ruling over the territory of Bihar and Bengal. And when the rule of Delhi Sultanates was established by slave dynasty, some of the capable and young Khiljis secured employment on the administrative and military posts, or in various military and administrative departments, some of the able Khiljis, they secured some of the post or positions. But later, mainly after the rule of Balban, this Jalaluddin Khilji founded the rule of Khilji dynasty in 1290 AD. Their Balban was one of the greatest ruler of slave dynasty. He was succeeded by Kaikabad. Here Kaikabad was a pleasure seeking ruler. So this Kaikabad's rule was ended by Jalaluddin Khilji. In 1290 AD, with the help of some Khilji amirs, Jalaluddin Khilji captured Kaikabad and later he murdered him. With this, the rule of slave dynasty came to an end, and this resulted in the beginning of Khilji's rule in Delhi. So here in the year 1290 AD, Jalaluddin Khilji founded the rule of Khilji dynasty in Delhi Sultanate. So here Jalaluddin Khilji was an age old sultan. When he came to power, he faced many difficulties, and some of the reasons were also resulted for his unpopularity. Many people, the nobles, then Khilji amirs also opposed his rule, or they were not supportive to Jalaluddin Khilji. So here we have some of the causes which were responsible for the unpopularity of Jalaluddin Khilji. Why he became unpopular in Delhi Sultanate? So here some of the reasons for his unpopularity were: first one, he murdered Kaikabad, the successor of slave dynasty, and this was not liked by the people. Especially people was not liked the assassination of the slave dynasty successor, that is Kaikabad. So people started hating the rule of Jalaluddin Khilji. Then another reason for his unpopularity is he lacked nobility of birth, means he was born in an ordinary family. The people of Delhi believed that only a person of royal origin or royal background could be the ruler of Delhi. Then there was no cordial relations between Khilji and Turks. There is no cordial relationship between especially Khilji and Turkish nobles. This is also resulted in mutual hatredness. Then Jalaluddin Khilji lacked those virtues which were needed in a sultan. Means here Jalaluddin Khilji was a kind-hearted person. Means he adopted various merciful policies in his administration or in his rule. Those policies were also resulted in his unpopularity. Then here Balban had established peace and consolidated the position of Delhi Sultanates. So here when the successor of Balban was assassinated by this Jalaluddin, that was not supported by the people. So all these were the reasons for the unpopularity of Jalaluddin Khilji during his succession. But after his succession, he followed some of the policies in order to rule effectively. Here he earned the confidence of the people by his benevolence, justice and religious contemplation. He adopted some of the changes in order to win over the people. After becoming the king, he decided to follow a policy of peace. He decided to follow a policy of peace, or he adopted peace. Means he was not prepared to use his sword even to punish the rebels and thieves or his enemies or his opponents. He was a sultan of very polite nature. This Jalaluddin became a sultan of polite nature and adopted various liberal policies. He considered himself an humble servant of Balban. So all these policies which were adopted after his succession were also resulted in his unpopularity. Especially nobles, then people, then Khilji Amirs started opposing the rule, that is the merciful nature of this Jalaluddin Khilji. Here some of the events or revolts were also broke out in his kingdom during his rule because of his merciful nature or because of his polite nature. Here one of the revolutionary known as Malik Chaju, he revolted against Jalaluddin Khilji in the year 1291 AD. And this Malik Chaju, he was an aspirant of the Delhi throne. Means he tried to acquire power over the Delhi Sultanate. But when he was planning to capture the throne of Delhi, at the same time this Khilji revolution was started. Means here Jalaluddin Khilji overthrown the rule of slave dynasty and established the rule of Khilji dynasty. And this was described as Khilji revolution by the historians. So here this Malik Chaju's revolt was suppressed by the son of Jalaluddin Khilji by name Arkali Khan. Arkali Khan was the son of Jalaluddin Khilji, suppressed the revolt of Malik Chaju and he was imprisoned. He was also imprisoned. But later Jalaluddin pardoned this Malik Chaju and treated him as his guest. And this is one of the best example for the liberal policy or merciful nature of Jalaluddin Khilji. Here taking advantage of the merciful nature of the Jalaluddin Khilji, the thieves, robbers, then Turks and other lawless elements started to harass the lives of the common people. When some of them were caught and brought in front of the Sultan, he gave them an attractive lecture about moral values. About moral values, then set them free. This is also created a severe hatredness for his rule. Mainly these nobles and Khilji Amirs not tolerated the policies of Jalaluddin Khilji. Then another reason for his downfall or weakness of his rule is Jalaluddin's foreign policy. His foreign policy was also very weak. Also followed very liberal techniques against his enemies. And at that time, this strict foreign policy is needed for the protection of the Sultanate. But Jalaluddin Khilji followed a liberal policy, that is liberal foreign policy. ಇಲ್ನೋಡಿ ಜಲ್ಲುದ್ದೀನ್ ಖಿಲ್ಜಿ ಆರಂಭದಿಂದ ಕೊನೆಯ ತನಕ ಕೂಡ ಒಬ್ಬ ಕರುಣಾಮಯಿ ದೊರೆಯಾಗಿ ಬರ್ತಾನೆ ಅಥವಾ ಒಬ್ಬ ಸುಲ್ತಾನ್ ಆಗಿ ಬರ್ತಾನೆ. ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂಡ ತುಂಬಾ ಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಅಥವಾ ಕಠಿಣವಾದ ಕ್ರಮಗಳನ್ನು ಅವನು ತೆಗೆದುಕೊಳ್ಳೋದೇ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಒಬ್ಬ ಕರುಣಾಮಯಿ ದಯಾಮಯನಾಗಿ ಆಳ್ವಿಕೆಯನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ. ಬಟ್ ಆ ರೀತಿಯ ಆಳ್ವಿಕೆ 13ನೇ ಶತಮಾನದಲ್ಲಿ ದೆಹಲಿಗೆ ಅಥವಾ ದೆಹಲಿಯ ಒಂದು ಸುಲ್ತಾನ್ ನೇಟ್ ಅನ್ನು ಏನೋ ಸಂರಕ್ಷಿಸಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಅದು ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಆಗ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಯಾಕೆಂದ್ರೆ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಕಡೆಯಿಂದ ಶತ್ರುಗಳೇ ಇದ್ರು. ಸೊ ಒಬ್ಬ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ರೂಲರ್, ಒಬ್ಬ ಪ್ರಭಾವಶಾಲಿ ಸುಲ್ತಾನ್ ನ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅವಶ್ಯಕತೆ ಇತ್ತು. ಆದ್ರಿಂದ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಕೂಡ ಜಲ್ಲುದ್ದೀನ್ ಖಿಲ್ಜಿ ಆಳ್ವಿಕೆಯನ್ನ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ವಿರೋಧಿಸ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆರಂಭಿಸ್ತಾರೆ. ಬಾಲ್ಬನ್ನ ನಂತರ ಅವನ ಉತ್ತರಾಧಿಕಾರಿಯಾಗಿ ಬಂದಂತಹ ಕೈಕಾಬಾದ್ ನನ್ನು ಯಾರು ಸೋಲಿಸ್ತಾನೆ, ಈ ಜಲ್ಲುದ್ದೀನ್ ಖಿಲ್ಜಿ ಸೋಲಿಸಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅವನನ್ನು ಕ್ಯಾಪ್ಚರ್ ಮಾಡಿ ನಂತರ ಅವನು ಮರ್ಡರ್ ಕೂಡ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ಖಿಲ್ಜಿ ವಂಶದ ಆಡಳಿತವನ್ನು ಆರಂಭಿಸ್ತಾನೆ. ಬಟ್ ನಂತರ ಈ ಜಲ್ಲುದ್ದೀನ್ ಖಿಲ್ಜಿ ತುಂಬಾ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತಾನೆ, ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂಡ ತುಂಬಾ ಕಠಿಣವಾದ ಕ್ರಮಗಳನ್ನು ತೆಗೆದುಕೊಳ್ಳುವುದಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಕೂಡ ಜಲ್ಲುದ್ದೀನ್ ಖಿಲ್ಜಿ ಆಡಳಿತವನ್ನು ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ವಿರೋಧಿಸ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆರಂಭಿಸ್ತಾರೆ. ಅಂಡ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಫಾರಿನ್ ಪಾಲಿಸಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಫಾಲೋಡ್ ವೀಕ್ ಪಾಲಿಸಿ. ಹಿ ಸೆಂಟ್ ಅನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆಡಿಷನ್ ಅಗೇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ ರಣತಂಬೋರ್, ರಜಪೂತ್ ಫೋರ್ಟ್. ಬಟ್ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಎನಿ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟಾನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಕುಡ್ ಬಿ ಅಚೀವ್ಡ್ ದಿ ಆರ್ಮಿ ವಾಸ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ಡ್ ಟು ರಿಟ್ರೀಟ್. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ರಣತಂಬೋರಿಗೆ ತಲುಪಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಸಾಧಿಸುವ ಮುಂಚೆನೆ ಅವನು ತನ್ನ ಸೈನ್ಯಕ್ಕೆ ವಾಪಸ್ ಬರ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಜ್ಞೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ. ಹಿ ಆರ್ಡರ್ಡ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಟ್ರೂಪ್ಸ್ ಟು ರಿಟ್ರೀಟ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಹಿ ಡಿಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಲೂಸ್ ದಿ ಲೈವ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಥೌಸಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೋಲ್ಜರ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಒನ್ ಫೋರ್ಟ್. ಹಿ ನೆವರ್ ವಾಂಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಲೂಸ್ ದಿ ಲೈವ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸೋಲ್ಜರ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಒನ್ ಫೋರ್ಟ್. ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಶೋಸ್ ದಿ ನಾನ್ ವಯಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಮರ್ಸಿಫುಲ್ ನೇಚರ್ ಆಫ್ Jalaluddin Khilji. Then against Mongols, he followed a kind of liberal policy. Here, during his rule, that is in 1292 AD, Mongols attacked Delhi or the regions of India. Here, against Mongols, he sent his soldiers, and his soldiers were also successfully suppressed the invasions of the Mongols. But later he permitted some of the Mongols to settle near the Delhi. So during the rule of Jalaluddin Khilji, many families of Mongols were settled near Delhi, and they were known as new Muslims. And this policy proved very disastrous to Jalaluddin and also to other sultans who ruled over Delhi Sultanate, because they created always troubles or problems to the Delhi sultans. So all these were the some of the policies of Jalaluddin Khilji as a sultan of Delhi. And here, during the rule of Jalaluddin Khilji, his nephew Alauddin Khilji led two successful expeditions. They were first one is against Bilsa. Against Bilsa. Bilsa is a province of Malwa. In 1292 AD, Alauddin Khilji, with the advice of Jalaluddin, led a successful expedition against Bilsa, and that region was ruled by the Hindu kings. Hindu rulers, they were ruling over that Bilsa region. Here Alauddin Khilji, he attacked Bilsa and treacherously defeated these Hindu rulers. After defeating Hindu rulers, he plundered lot of wealth in the form of war booty. He captured gold, silver, horses, then elephants. And with this victory of Alauddin Khilji, Jalaluddin was much delighted. He was much delighted and immensely pleased. Later, he was with that great pleasure or immense pleasure appointed Alauddin Khilji as his war minister, and also granted the province of Awadh to Alauddin Khilji. Or here, Alauddin Khilji was appointed as the governor of Awadh province by Jalaluddin Khilji because of his victory over Bilsa region. After this successful expedition, Alauddin Khilji led another expedition against Devagiri. Actually, here Alauddin Khilji was the nephew of Jalaluddin Khilji. Alauddin Khilji yaro, Jalaluddin Khilji sodaralya. Adre illi Alauddin Khilji Jalaluddin Khilji ginta tumba enagidda, usahiyagidda, ashte allade tumba eno diplomatically kuda tumba enagidda, expert agidda. Jalaluddin tara tumba enagidda nishtavantanagi athava ellavannu ellarannu nambikondu ಹೋಗುವಂತವನಾಗಿರಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಇವನಿಗೆ ಸಾಧಿಸುವ ಛಲ ಇತ್ತು. ಅದನ್ನ ಬಿಲ್ಸದ ಮೇಲೆ ಇವನು ದಾಳಿಯನ್ನು ಸಂಘಟಿಸಿದ ನಂತರ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಸಕ್ಸಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಪಡಿತಾನೆ, ತುಂಬಾ ಸಂಪತ್ತನ್ನು ದೋಚ್ತಾನೆ. ನಂತರ ಅದರಿಂದ ಸಂತೋಷಗೊಂಡಂತಹ ಜಲ್ಲುದ್ದೀನ್ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ, ಅಲ್ಲಾವುದ್ದೀನನ್ನು ತನ್ನ ವಾರ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಅನ್ನಾಗಿ, ಯುದ್ಧ ಮಂತ್ರಿಯನ್ನಾಗಿ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ. ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಅಲ್ಲದೆ ಅವಧನ ಗವರ್ನರ್ನಾಗಿ ನೇಮಕ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ. ಸೊ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಾವುದ್ದೀನ್ ಖಿಲ್ಜಿ ಲೆಟ್ another expedition against Devagiri. Here during his invasion of Bilsa, Alauddin heard of the wealth of Devagiri. A Yadava ruler, Raja Ramachandra Deva, was ruling over Devagiri. At that time, the ruler of Devagiri was Raja Ramachandra Deva. And here Alauddin Khilji, he was inspired by the victory of Bilsa, and he was also wanted to capture wealth of Devagiri. He was greatly inspired by the victory against Bilsa, marched against Devagiri. That is in 1296 AD. He reached the gates of Devagiri, and when the forces of Alauddin Khilji reached or crossed the gates of Devagiri, the ruler Raja Ramachandra Deva was shocked because he was not made any sufficient arrangements to meet the enemies. So he was greatly shocked, and finally he was also defeated by Alauddin Khilji. So here, after the defeat, he agreed to pay a huge amount of war indemnity or war booty to Alauddin Khilji. He paid lot of wealth to Alauddin Khilji and also hand over some of the rich territories to Alauddin. And with this war booty, this Alauddin returned to Kara. Kara means that is near UP, Uttar Pradesh, and it is one of the important region of the Delhi Sultanates. Here, after his success, Alauddin, he never went to Delhi. He went to Kara because he Yet the success of Alauddin against Devagiri made him to think how to become the permanent owner of the Delhi region or Delhi Sultanate. So here the wealth of Devagiri made Alauddin to think how to become the permanent owner of it. So he did not go to Delhi. He went to Karam and he was also invited Sultan Jalaluddin Khilji to Kara. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ ಅಲ್ಲಾವುದ್ದೀನ್ ದೇವಗಿರಿಯ ವಿರುದ್ಧ ಜಯವನ್ನು ಕಳಿಸಿದ ನಂತರ ಸಾಕಷ್ಟು ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ ಸಂಪತ್ತನ್ನು ತನ್ನದಾಗಿಸಿಕೊಳ್ತಾನೆ. ಯುದ್ಧದಲ್ಲಿ ಜಯವನ್ನು ಗಳಿಸೋದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಕಪ್ಪ ಕಾಣಿಕೆಯನ್ನು ಪಡಿತಾನೆ, ಅದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಪಡೆದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗ್ತಾನೆ, ಕಾರಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಾನೆ. ಕಾರ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಉತ್ತರ ಪ್ರದೇಶ ಹತ್ತಿರ ಇರುವಂತಹ ಒಂದು ಡೆಲ್ಲಿ ಸುಲ್ತಾನರ ಪ್ರದೇಶವಾಗಿತ್ತು. ಚಿಲವನ್ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಕಿತ್ತು? ಡೆಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಕಿತ್ತು. ಡೆಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಯಾಕೆ ಹೋಗ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ? ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅಲ್ಲಾವುದ್ದೀನ್ಗೆ ಅಧಿಕಾರದ ಆಸೆ ಇತ್ತು ಅಲ್ವಾ, ಅಧಿಕಾರದವನಿಗೆ ಆಸೆ ಇತ್ತು. ಸೊ ಅವನು ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಡೆಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಹೋಗಿ ಜಲಾಲುದ್ದೀನ್ ಅನ್ನು ಭೇಟಿಯಾಗಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಅಥವಾ ಅವನಿಗೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ರೀತಿಯ ವಾರ್ ಬ್ಯೂಟಿ ಅಥವಾ ಏನು ಯುದ್ಧದಿಂದ ಅವನು ವಶಪಡಿಸಿಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದಾನೆ ಅದು ಯಾವ ಸಂಪತ್ತನ್ನು ನೀಡುವುದಿಲ್ಲ. ಬದಲಾಗಿ ಅವನು ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗ್ತಾನೆ? ಕಾರಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಾನೆ. ವೆನ್ ಹಿ ರೀಚ್ಡ್ ಕಾರಾ ಹಿ ಇನ್ವೈಟೆಡ್ ಜಲಾಲುದ್ದೀನ್ ಖಿಲ್ಜಿ ಟು ಕಾರಾ. Here, without caring for the advice of his worthy ministers, Jalaluddin Khilji proceeded to Kara as he had great affection for Alauddin Khilji, because Alauddin Khilji was his nephew, so he was not cared. Some of the advices which were given by his ministers, mainly his various ministers were also advised to this Jalaluddin Khilji about the plans of Alauddin Khilji. But his Jalaluddin Khilji, he reached this Kara with a great affection for Alauddin. He had a greater affection and love about Alauddin Khilji. Here, when this Alauddin Jalaluddin Khilji reached Kara, Alauddin and his associates killed Jalaluddin Khilji. That is, in 1296, this Jalaluddin Khilji was assassinated or killed by Alauddin Khilji and his associates or his supporters. So here the old Sultan Jalaluddin Khilji was murdered or killed by Alauddin Khilji, that is, in 19 July 1296 AD. So after the death of Jalaluddin, Alauddin Khilji declared himself as the Sultan of Delhi, that is, on 20th July 1296 AD, Alauddin Khilji declared himself as the Sultan of Delhi. With this, the rule of kind-hearted and unsuspecting Jalaluddin Khilji came to an end, that is, on 19 July 1296 AD. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿ, ಅನ್ಸಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅವನು ಯಾರು ಸಂಶಯ ಪಡೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅಲ್ಲಾವುದ್ದೀನ್ ಜಲಾಲುದ್ದೀನ್ ಅನ್ನು ಕಾರಕ್ಕೆ ಇನ್ವೈಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗಲೂ ಯಾಕೆ ಇವನು ಡೆಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಬರಲಿಲ್ಲ, ನನ್ನನ್ನು ಯಾಕೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಕರೀತಿದ್ದಾನೆ ಎಂಬ ಯಾವುದೇ ಅನುಮಾನ ಬರಲಿಲ್ಲ ಅವನಿಗೆ. ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಅವನು ಅಷ್ಟು ಒಬ್ಬ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಹಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಮರ್ಸಿಫುಲ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದ. ಸೊ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ ಅವನು, ತನ್ನ ಅಳಿಯನಾದಂತಹ ಈ ಅಲ್ಲಾವುದ್ದೀನನ್ನು ತುಂಬಾ ನಂಬಿಕೆ ಇಟ್ಟಿರ್ತಾನೆ, ನಂಬ್ತಾನೆ, ಮತ್ತೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಾನೆ. ಬಟ್ ಅವನು ಕಾರಕ್ಕೆ ರೀಚ್ ಆದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ಅಲ್ಲಾವುದ್ದೀನ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಅವನ ಸಂಗಡಿಗರು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಮರ್ಡರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಅಸಾಸಿನೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಅಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಜಲಾಲುದ್ದೀನ್ ಖಿಲ್ಜಿಯ ಆಳ್ವಿಕೆ ಕೊನೆಗೊಳ್ತದೆ. ಅದು ಯಾವಾಗ? 19 ಜುಲೈ 1296. ಸೊ 20 ಜುಲೈ 1296 ಅಲ್ಲಾವುದ್ದೀನ್ ಖಿಲ್ಜಿಯು ದೆಹಲಿಯ ಸುಲ್ತಾನ್ ಆಗಿ ಆಳ್ವಿಕೆಯನ್ನು ಆರಂಭಿಸ್ತಾನೆ. ಸೊ ವಿತ್ ದಿಸ್ ದಿ ರೂಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಜಲಾಲುದ್ದೀನ್ ಖಿಲ್ಜಿ ವಾಸ್ ಕೇಮ್ ಟು ಅನ್ ಎಂಡ್, ಅಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಗೇವ್ ಅನ್ opportunity to Alauddin Khilji to rule over Delhi Sultanate. So this is about the foundation of Khilji dynasty and also the rule of Jalaluddin Khilji. Thank you, students.